Hey, Pink Squad, Alex Taylor here, and this is my dad, Dennis Taylor.
Dennis Taylor.
That's you.
That's me.
That is. And we are in his shop currently. You guys have seen a shop tour before. We've done that. But you guys want to go through and talk about a couple of random memories that we see that walking around here sparks?
Man, there's a lot of them.
Well, you've had this for how long? Like, you built the front shop in?
91.
91. And then I've been here since 97. So this has got my whole life in the shop. So lots of stuff.
We don't know anything besides this shop.
That's what I keep saying. Except now we have my shop over there, so now we have two shops.
We get to start new memories.
Yeah, okay. So let's go through and pick a couple things. So first, this is a really random one, but I'm gonna go with it. You guys know how you have like those whiteboards and stuff that you draw on? This shop floor, all of this concrete, 8,000 square foot of it, is a chalkboard. And here you can see, I remember very clearly being under the lift over there, kneeled down, looking, and I remember Dad teaching me how to do stuff that involved pi, like circumference and stuff like that. And it was because we used the concrete as a chalkboard, as a teaching method.
And I have my, what do you call it, not crayon.
Sharpie.
Chalk.
Oh yeah.
My chalk.
Yeah.
It stays with me at all times. There's been times in here where, I mean a couple different times where I went around with paint thinner or something and clean the floor because, you know, the eraser.
You run out of room.
It was, I was getting confused. There was so much on the floor. So, I'd go to look for something and it'd be like, which spot was it?
Where's the note that? So the concrete itself has had a lot of writing. It's kind of empty right now, but we had a lesson on kingpin inclination the other day. So chalkboard floor, that's one thing. Up here, let's pick something random, like this airplane.
How about that swing?
Oh, that swing, that's a good one. Okay, so you guys see the straps up there?
And there's boards.
There's a board right there. Megan and I grew up here, literally, that's all we did. So Dad would make toys and stuff for us to play with. And one of those was the swing here, these swings. So they're straps like you strap a car down with. They have a board tied to them.
That's been up there for what now? Without moving for 20 years probably?
It's moved in 20 years.
Has it?
Yeah, because I, yeah.
But when you were real small, I'd get back there. Of course, that trailer wasn't there. When you go way up,
yeah,
both directions.
Yeah, so the swings are stuff there. We had a pole that we could climb up and down and stuff. Like, this was a kind of a jungle gym area right here with swings. So yeah, that's a good one.
So you remember the hand truck, the two-wheeler?
Yeah, I remember
that.
And we
made some siding that I had, some tin siding.
Yeah.
So out back, I made you a ramp and it went way down and you guys would put that two-wheeler on there.
Like a dolly.
Pile on top of it.
Yeah.
Nowadays, you'd have to have helmets and protect elbow pads.
Yeah,
or I'd be arrested for child abuse.
Built it out a square TV like and put siding. Yeah, and we had all kinds of different stuff. Like, we'd get on the dolly, my friends would come over and we'd...
Skateboards.
Skateboards. There's a hill in the back where we'd like skateboard. So we did all kinds of stuff here. I caught a lot of bugs, had bug catchers and stuff here.
You ate onions, remember?
Oh yeah, so one time, if you walk out to the grass and you check out the little green things that are growing up.
Onions.
My mom.
We have a lot of onions in Arkansas.
We do, and they played a really memorable April Fool's joke here. And they told me and my sister, because we like to pick the onions, like pull them up by the roots and see the little onion ball, we collect them and like sell them on our markets. They told us that if you pick those and you chew them, they taste just like vanilla.
It took a lot of convincing.
They don't taste like vanilla.
They
April Fool's.
It was a joke.
Yeah.
And then I laughed really hard.
Oh, he did. He got a lot of enjoyment. Remember that still. What else is here that's like a very random something?
A very random memory for you? Man, I mean.
I remember that postage stamp up there. That was a little postage stamp machine. I remember repairing it in the living room floor and making it where it spit out postage stamp books. And then up there in the corner, there's a purple ball. I actually want that. Hang on. I was looking. I almost bought one of these the other day. We've had all kinds of toys hiding around the shop, like, because this is where we were. And I almost bought one of these the other day because I saw it at the zoo. And I was like, is that still up there? So we had all kinds of...
Yeah, now let's close it down.
Yeah. So we had all kinds of stuff like that. But now most of our memories involve lots of late nights working on
We just got finished with one of those.
Yes, we did.
I mean, so for us, it's work 24/7, and we literally live the life.
Yeah.
We don't know anything else. We take our boat out once a year if we're lucky.
That's true. That's true. But tons of stuff that we've done around here. But we have a ton more stuff that we're going to be doing in the future. Got all kinds of ideas.
So you know that pile of skateboards right there?
Oh, that's true. We can hit one more. We have a collection. I built Dad this skateboard for Father's Day. This one he's had forever. That's one he just got in California, but like, we've spent many hours riding skateboards around here.
And we're gonna spend many more over here.
That's true. You wanna take a skateboard?
Over there?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can skate over there.
Okay, let's take one. Let's take a pic.
Take the blue stripe one.
Okay. So, with that said, speaking of new memories we're gonna create, my shop is right across the road. It's like, used to be a dollar store. Looked at it for many years. Remember walking across the road and getting ice cream and then walking back here.
Well, you know what's funny about that is all the years that was a dollar store over there, I don't think I ever went in. I don't. And then it turned into a lawnmower repair shop. I was never in the lawnmower repair shop.
That's very true. Now you're in it.
I'm in it a lot. But you know, it's kind of like the Walmart here. I think I've been in it once or twice.
That's so, also
I don't
true.
Get out of the shop very often.
We have a very small town and he sees very little except the shops. There's plenty more stuff to come. And getting this shop actually opens up a lot more that we can do in that shop too.
That's going to be the workshop. This is going to be the what?
Show fun shop. Yeah.
Fun shop.
So we have so many different project ideas. Like we've ran out of space over there. And over here, there's going to be lifts all along the back wall. Where we can store cars, where we can film fun videos and things, do podcasts. I'm gonna have a little fabrication corner. We're gonna have an area where we can do merchandise and shipping and all that kind of stuff. So we have constantly have different like, oh, we can make this and sell it ideas too.
And our eyes are like this big.
Yeah.
And our plate's really not that big.
But we're getting much better at scheduling stuff.
We have lots of ambition and we run out of time all the time.
We're getting better.
We're getting there.
Anyways.
She said so.
We are. It's on the schedule. It said so.
It's scheduled. That's true. She has all our projects scheduled. So whether we're ready to do them or not, we do them.
Yeah, it just has to happen. So anyways, that's the current state of the compound here. We have a compound going on.
We got to build that tunnel underneath the ground.
I'm down for that. That's actually cool.
That would be cool.
Okay, so plenty of memories had, plenty more to come, and you guys can stay tuned and follow along for that, and it's gonna be a good time.